Hello everyone, today we have a new topic to discuss about because recently Union Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change has released the detailed status of the Tiger Report 2018. In that report, it is said that there is an increase of about 6% population of tigers per annum during the year 2006 and 2018. So today let us see the details of the report. And as it is very important for the prelims point of view and had many questions regarding the tigers in previous year's prelims exams, let us also have a small outline about the Project Tiger, NTCA and various tiger reserves in India. In this report, it is said that there is some increase in the number of tigers in states like Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and there is a decrease in number of tigers in states like Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Odisha. And also about 70% of world's tiger population is in India, and as tiger is an umbrella species, which means that conservation of tiger will conserve the entire ecosystem. Many studies have shown that this reserve, which has tiger, harbors a new species every year. Tiger reserves have also improved the water availability in the region. For example, there is an improvement in the groundwater table in that area, and this is considered as a good trend, as conservation of one species is automatically benefiting the other species also. With the increase in the population of tigers, there is also a risk of increase in man-animal conflict. Tigers coming out from the forest to the human habitat area has become a common phenomena now. To prevent this act, there is also a solution mentioned during the release of this report, that is water and fodder scheme. The ministry will be starting a water and fodder scheme within the reserve so that less animals will be coming out of this forest in search of food and water. Less the number of animals coming out of the forest means less number of human animal conflict. Okay. Another important point is that in the Western Ghat region, that is in the Nagahol, Bandipur, Wayanad, Mudumalai, Satyamangalam, BRT block, we have largest contiguous tiger population in the world. That is about 724 tiger. Contiguous means continuous area. Usually there will be a break between one tiger reserve to another, but here in the Western Ghat it is continuous throughout and has about 724 tigers, which is world's largest in contiguous area. Next, let us see something about the Project Tiger, as this is also an important topic for prelims. This is started in 1973. When started, there was only 9 tiger reserves at that time, but now it has increased to 50 tiger reserves in the year 2018, and this tiger reserve is protecting tiger and its habitat through the core and buffer strategy. This is also important for prelims. Okay, here you can see the core and buffer area of Kanha Tiger Reserve. Light green is core area and dark green is buffer zone. In core zone, this area is totally free from all disturbances and no activities are allowed here. In the buffer zone, some activities are allowed, like tourism. For example, in Periyar Tiger Reserves of Kerala, you can see tourism here. You can also see Shabrimala pilgrimage and some other activities in the buffer zone. So in core zone, no activities are allowed, where in the buffer zone, some activities are allowed. This is how tiger reserves work. Then note that the Project Tiger is a centrally sponsored scheme, which means that the fund will be taken jointly by the center and the states. Actually, we have two kind of schemes. One is central sector scheme and the other is centrally sponsored scheme. In central sector scheme, fund will be completely provided by the center, but in the centrally sponsored scheme, fund will be jointly contributed by both center and the states. In this Project Tiger, this is a centrally sponsored scheme, which means fund will be jointly by both center and the states. Okay, now let's have a view of the map of India. Here you can see the map of India with tiger reserves in it. learned this map by noting each tiger reserves and its states, because already there was a question in prelims of match the following of tiger reserves and concerned states. Okay, so just have an idea about the tiger reserves and the state's name in which the tiger reserve is located. Now let us see about the National Tiger Conservation Authority, in short NTCA. This is also a very important topic for UPSC, so at least have these points in your mind. Okay, one is, this is launched in 2005 and is a statutory body. When it was started, it was not a statutory body. It got statutory status by 2006 only, with an amendment to Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, and is working under Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Okay. So just have an idea about all these things related with the tiger, because tiger as well as its conservation activities are very important for the UPSC exam, including the Project Tiger as well as the National Tiger Conservation Authority. So keep these points in mind. Thank you.